Good morning everybody. In this video, you will find explanation of the third part of Act 3, Scene 2. That is continuation of Act 3, Scene 2. Before this, we studied that Bassanio made the right choice of casket and won Portia. He is so happy that he is dazed by his victory and therefore wants Portia to confirm his happiness. Now let's begin with today's text. Portia. You see me, Lord Bassanio, where I stand, such as I am. You see me, Lord Bassanio, as I stand here, as I am in reality. Though for myself alone, I would not be ambitious in my wish, to wish myself much better. As far as my desires are concerned, I would have no ambitious wish that I might be better. But for you, I would be troubled 20 times myself. But just for your sake, I wish that I might be 3 times of 20 of what I am. 1,000 times more fair, 10,000 times more rich. I wish that I would be 1,000 times more beautiful, 10,000 times more rich, that only to stand high in your estimation. And all this so that you can hold me high in your account, in your estimation. I might in virtues, beauties, livings, friend, exceed amount. I might be in my qualities, in my beauty, in my property, friend, exceed, have a lot. But the full sum of me in sum of something which to term in gross is an unlessoned girl, unschooled, unpracticed. But the sum total of myself is total of which may be expressed in a brief as an inexperienced girl, untrained girl. Happy in this, she is yet not yet so old, but she may learn. I am happy in this point that I am not too old to learn. Happier than this, she is not bred so dull, but she can learn. And even happier because I am not slow in nature and I can still learn. Happiest of all is that her gentle spirit commits itself to yourself to be directed. And I am happiest of all in this feeling that I give my gentle spirit, which I entrust to your spirit to be guided. As from her Lord, her Governor, her King. So I give my spirit to my Lord, my Governor, her King. That is all Bunyan. Here Portia, she is very virtuous, beautiful, wealthy. But still, she feels very low in front of Bassanio. Because she is happy, so happy that Bassanio has chosen the right casket. Therefore, she says that she wished to be much more than what she is actually in terms of beauty, in terms of virtue and also richness, so that Antonio can hold her high in his estimation. Myself and what is mine to you and yours is now converted, but now I was the lord of this fair mansion, master of my servant, queen over myself. As from her Lord, her Governor, her King. I myself, and what is mine is now yours, all belongs to you. But now I was the Lord. Just a moment ago, I was the Lord of this fair, beautiful mansion. I was the master of my servant. I was the queen of myself. That means I could do anything I wish to. And even now, but now, This house, this servant, and the same myself are yours, my Lord. And at this very moment, this beautiful house, all the servants that belong to me, and me, myself, are all yours. I give them with this ring, which when you part from, lose or give away. I give you all these things with a ring, which if you part with, let it presage the ruin of a love and be my vantage to claim on you. Let that be the sign that your love for me is dead, and I may then accuse you of it. So Portia hands over everything she possessed to Bassanio along with the ring and expects Bassanio to keep the ring with him forever. Bassanio: Madam, you have bereft me of all words. Only my blood speaks to you in my vein. Madam, you have deprived me of all word. Only the blood that runs in my vein can speak. And there is such confusion in my power, and there is same confusion in my physical sense, as after some oration fairly spoke by a beloved king, there doth appear among the buzzing pleased multitude, as after a speech which is very well spoken by a beloved king, the confusion that appears among the murmuring happy audience, that same confusion I feel in my sense, where every something being blend together turns to a wild of nothing, save of joy expressed and unexpressed, where everything is been mixed up together, all emotions are mixed up together, and just produces a wild, confusing expression, and that is of joy, whether expressed or not expressed. So here Bassanio, when he hears Portia speak, he is so happy to have heard of that, of Portia's feeling, that he cannot express himself anymore now. But when this ring parts from this finger, then parts life from hence. And as far as the ring is concerned, when this ring parts from me, then my life too will part from me, and then be bold to say Bassanio's dead, and then be bold enough and you can say that I am dead, I am no more. So Bassanio promises to keep this ring forever, and only he will part from it when he dies. This gifting of ring plays an important role. We will find this later in the play. Naresa: My lord and lady, it is our time that have stood by and seen our wishes prosper, to cry good joy, my lord and lady. My lord and lady, referring to Bassanio and Portia, it is now our time, who had been standing beside and watching our wishes being fulfilled, to wish you good joy, to wish you for your desires being fulfilled. Graciano: My lord Bassanio and my gentle lady, I wish you all the joy that you can wish, for I am sure you can wish none from me. So my lord Bassanio and my gentle lady Portia, I wish you all the happiness that you can wish for yourself, and I am sure that you cannot wish for anything more than I am wishing for you. And when your honors mean to solemnize the bargain of your faith, I do beseech you, even at that time I may be married too. And when your honor, you and Portia, mean to celebrate the contract of your love, I request you, at the same time I too be married. Bassanio: With all my heart, so thou canst get away. So with all my heart I allow you, provided you find a wife for yourself. Graciano, I thank your lordship, you have got me one. I thank you, Bassanio, for getting me one, for getting me a wife. My eyes, my lord, can look as swift as yours. You saw the mistress, I beheld the maid. So my eyes had looked as quick as your eye did. You saw the mistress, and I saw the maid. You loved, I loved. You loved, and I too fell in love. For intermission, no more pertains to me, my lord, than you. Now, a period of waiting will be no more agreeable to me than to you. Your fortune stood upon the casket there, and so did mine too, as the matter falls. Your fortune, your luck, dependent on the casket, and my luck too, as the things turn out to be. For wooing here until I sweat again, and swearing till my very roof was dry with oaths of love, I had been proposing her with all my energy, and swearing promises of love till the roof of my mouth got dry. At last, a promise last, I got a promise of this fair one here to have her love. And if promise, her promise still holds true, I got her promise, that is Narissa's promise, to have her love, provided that your fortune achieved her mistress, on a condition that if you were lucky enough to win Portia. Here Graciano is proposing marriage to Portia and wants Bassanio's permission for that. Portia, is this true, Narissa? Narissa, madam, it is, so you stand pleased with all. Yes, madam, it is, provided that you are happy with it. Bassanio, and do you, Graciano, mean good faith? And, Graciano, do you have intention of marrying her in good faith? Graciano, yes, faith, my lord. Yes, in good faith, my lord. Bassanio, our feast shall be much honored in your marriage. Our marriage shall be much honored by having your marriage added to it. Graciano, but who comes here? But who is coming towards us? Lorenzo and his infidel. Lorenzo and his infidel. Infidel is, Jessica is being referred to here as infidel. Infidel means a non-believer of Christianity. Since she is Jew and not a Christian, therefore being called infidel. What? And my old Venetian friend, Salerio, and accompanied by Salerio. So here I end with the explanation of the third part of Act 3, Scene 2. You will find the explanation of the leftover scene in the next video. Thank you.